अस्सलाम वालेकुम, नमस्ते एंड वेलकम टू द न्यूज आवर विद योर फेवरेट होस्ट एंड दोस्त जेनिफर रॉजर्स। एंड इफ यू आर न्यू टू आवर चैनल, डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू शेयर दिस वीडियो विद ऑल योर फ्रेंड्स एंड फैमिली सो दे आर अवेयर अबाउट ऑल द थिंग्स हैपनिंग इन कतर एंड ऑल अराउंड द वर्ल्ड। एंड विद दैट वी आर ऑल्सो अवेलेबल ऑन ट्विटर, यूट्यूब, फेसबुक एंड इंस्टाग्राम। सो इफ यू आर नॉट फॉलोइंग अस ऑन आर अदर सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म्स, प्लीज गो अहेड एंड डू सो। एंड विद दैट आई हैव अबाउट three local updates for you and two international updates, so let's just get into it. So the first one is QU public health graduate volunteer to help tackle COVID-19 pandemic. So a total of 16 Qatar University graduates joined the MOPH in collecting data about quarantine patients and accessing workers' needs in different settings to plan for distance awareness sessions. Now public health volunteers from the College of Health Science, CHS, at Qatar University have volunteered at the Ministry of Public Health through its national volunteering campaign to tackle the COVID-19 pandemic. During the first 2 months of the pandemic, public health volunteers support the team at the ministry in tackling the implementation of some of the epidemic measures, accessing public needs, and developing awareness plans. They enhance the public awareness by organizing booths in public places and working at call centers at the MOPH to respond to public concerns. Now they have also volunteers have also helped in collecting data about patients in quarantine and accessing workers' needs in different settings to plan for distance awareness sessions. Now Dr. Hanan Abdul Rahim, Dean of the College of the College of Health Science, said volunteering with the Ministry of Public Health has been a tremendous opportunity for graduates of the public health program to witness up close the tremendous efforts in all fronts, including disease surveillances and community health education, as well as to put up in practice what they have been learning in their academic lives. We are very, very grateful to the colleagues at the Ministry of Public Health for their efforts in mentoring the graduates. Now, with that, let's get to the second update of the day, which is the 26 health facilities in Qatar that have been approved by the Ministry for the COVID-19 PCR test. Now, the Ministry of Public Health has published a list of 26 health facilities that have been approved by them to make the PCR test for COVID-19. Virus in Qatar. Now I'm going to put down the name of all these 26 centers in the comment section, because it's just too long for me to talk about it right now and I don't want to bore you guys as well. So I'm just going to put it down in the comment section, the name of all the 26 centers that the ministry has approved, and you can check it out in the comment section. Now with that, let's get to the third update of the day, which is Doha Metro bus services to resume at 30% capacity from September 1st. So as Qatar continues its precautionary measures to ensure the well-being and safety of citizens and residents against the coronavirus pandemic, the Ministry of Transport and Communication has announced measures for resuming public transit services within the first phase of the phase 4 of the gradual lifting of coronavirus restrictions. Now operations of the public transport buses and metro can resume services at 30% capacity as for September 1st. Service hours will be the same as they have been before the service suspension, while the situation will be accessed on weekly basis. Now the MOTC stresses the need of all operations for public transports to comply with the precautionary measures set by the Ministry of Public Health, run a COVID-19 test for all those who work on the public transport system and stations, and ensure a negative result before going back to work. Now, those measures are also include checking their temperature daily and continuously, isolating those who exhibit any of these disease symptoms, and contacting their body concern for any necessary precautions and health measures. Operators will also be training their staff in applying such precautionary measures to prevent the spread of the virus. Now, starting September 1st, resuming public transport buses and metro service at 30% capacity, according to the previous working hours of the public transit, will be abiding to the MOPH guidelines and instructions. Testing all workers for public transport systems and stations for coronavirus will be mandatory. Now, providing supervisors to ensure all precautionary measures are being followed. Encouraging customers to pre-book ride tickets online. Allowing entry only for those with green status on their Yatra's app and those who wear face masks. Banning smoking at the entrance of the public transport and following instructions on the guidelines given. After that, banning eating and drinking inside station or in the public transport system. Surfaces should be continuously sanitized. Social distance should be maintained. Foot marks and signs to be placed on the walls and the floors and the seats. Hand sanitizers should be stationed everywhere. And with that, let's get to the international news of the day, which is the IPL league. Two players among 13 have been tested positive for coronavirus, says BCCI. Now, two players among the 13 players involved in the delay of the Indian Premier League that have been tested positive for coronavirus in the United Arab Emirates. The Board of Control of Cricket in India, the BCCI, says 1,998 tests were carried between the 20th to the 28th of August, and all those affected as well as those in close contact have been asymptomatic. Now, according to ESPN, the two players, one an Indian and one international, are among the 10 cases at Chennai Super Kings, with support staff, net bowlers and team officials' wife also testing positive. Those to test positive are now being monitored at different hotels and must spend at least 2 weeks in quarantine. All 53 IPL games will be played in UAE based for the global COVID-19 pandemic. The Super Kings were the three-time champions, arrived on the 21st of August, and the team was scheduled to be in training in Dubai on Friday. Now, the sessions have been postponed to 1st September, with the IPL to set start on the 19th of September. Meanwhile, Super Kings all-rounder Suresh Raina, who is the competition's second highest runner scorer, has returned to India for personal reasons and will not be playing the IPL and not taking part in this tournament this year. Now, let's get to the second update of the day, which is Mauritius oil spill. Thousands march in the Port Louis. Thousands of people have marched through the Mauritian capital, Port Louis, in protest to authorities handling out a massive oil spill and the discovery of 39 dead dolphins. Many wore black and waved the national flags while honking and drumming. Many called for governments to resign, and the t-shirts with inscriptions written on them, "I love my country, but I am ashamed of my government." Now, it is the biggest protest that the country has seen in the recent years. About 1,000 tons of oil spilled into sanctuary for rare wildlife after the Japanese ship MV Wasashio struck in a coral reef on the 25th of July. Now, many Mauritians believe that the government could have done a lot to prevent the spill, but there is also criticisms over the decision to deliberately sink a part of the ship after the ship split into two. Now, at Saturday's protest, one woman told the BBC that, "I am present today because we all want to know the truth. They didn't do anything when the ship approached our coastline. 12 days, they didn't do anything until the oil started spilling, and now thousands of people and marine people are affected." Mauritius is in a situation right now that also holds demonstrations in the city, including London, Paris and Perth. The government has promised to set up commissions to investigate the spill. The captain of the ship has been arrested and charged with endangering safe navigations. He is yet to comment over this. It is not yet clear whether the cause of the death of the dolphins were found washed up on the shore this week. Experts have examined two of the dolphins' body and say that they have bite marks of sharks, but could not find any trace of hydrocarbon in their body. Environmental campaigners have demanded an independent investigation, saying that they were either killed as a direct result of the spill or then were scuttled. Tourism is a major industry in the Indian Ocean National Nation, and the spill has been a massive blow to the country, coming up on top of the coronavirus pandemic, which has restricted international travel this year. Now, with this, I'm done with all the updates for today. Thank you so much for logging on to Qatar Day. Keep loving, keep supporting, keep watching Qatar Day, the pulse of the nation. Me, your host and those Jennifer Rogers, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Same time, same place with more news about all the things happening in Qatar and all around the world. So remember to stay home, stay safe, look after yourself. And it's very, very healthy right now. It's very, very important right now to stay healthy. So take care of yourself. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Khuda hafiz. Bye-bye.